Hi everybody, my name is Jim with Full Moon Adventure Club, and today we're doing a simple video on how to determine whether or not you have power draw on your battery using a multimeter in your RV. Now, power draw is basically little power vampires in your RV that are slowly draining small amounts of power from your battery that you might not know about. So you turn the engine key off or you turn off everything in the RV. This is a way to check to see if there's anything left on that is drawing small amounts of power from your battery. And all you need to do this is a multimeter. They're about 20 bucks. They're incredibly handy tools. I'll put a link down below for an Amazon one that's real cheap. But they can diagnose a multitude of electrical problems, including power draw. It could be a LCD display, maybe a clock display, your stereo, maybe a small LED light in a cabinet somewhere that you're unaware of. And these can slowly drain power out of your battery over time, so that if you leave for a few days, you come back, your battery might be dead, or you're just not going to be getting enough use out of your battery because something's always drawing current and you want to stop that. When you turn things off, you want them to be off. So I'm going to show you how to diagnose power draw right now. Okay, so here we have our standard voltmeter and we have it set up to read voltage. And so we're gonna check this battery here. This is a 12 volt lead acid battery and it's showing 12.63 volts. So that's perfectly charged and ready to go, ready to test with. And so now we're gonna switch the voltmeter over to check for amps. You do this by moving the red test lead over to the amp side and then adjusting your dial to read amps. Now, before you do this test, you need to make sure you turn off everything you possibly can in the RV. Everything you can think of, because we're about to run all power going to the RV through this voltmeter and it can only handle about 10 amps. The smaller ones can anyway. So 10 amps. So if you have your refrigerator or a bunch of lights or a fan or your air conditioner on or something and you try and run all that power through your voltmeter, you're gonna blow the little 10 amp fuse and you're gonna have to replace that and start over. So with everything that you can possibly think of turned off, we're gonna take off the negative terminal of the battery and connect that to the positive test lead of the voltmeter, or in this case, amp meter. And then we're gonna attach the negative test lead to the negative terminal of the battery so that any power flowing from this battery going into your RV is gonna go through our amp meter right here, and it will be able to detect the most minuscule amount of amps that are coming out of this battery. So you should be at zero. If you see zero right now, that's fantastic. You have no amp draw whatsoever. That's awesome. Now we're going to turn on this little light, which is connected to the RV. And so the energy for that light has to pass through the negative terminal and through the multimeter into the battery. So once I turn this light on, now you can see that we have a 0.16 amp draw from that one LED light. And that is how you check for amp draw. When you turn it off, it goes away. When you turn it on, it's going to come on. That's going to let you know how much power you're losing. And give you an indication of whether or not that's acceptable. If you have a little LED light on a clock or a stereo or your refrigerator display or your TV antenna booster, signal booster, stuff like that, so many little things, you just have to make the determination of whether or not those are acceptable for how long you're gonna be leaving your battery without being charged. So once you find all that stuff, and you turn something off and you see your amperage go to zero, then you know you found your culprit, your little power vampire, and you can address that situation with a battery disconnect or by turning off that device every time you leave the RV. So there you go. So there you go. If you have zero power draw, you're good to go. Your battery is going to be ready to use it when you want to use it. If you do have power draw, this is an excellent way to start tracking down the problem to make sure that you can get yourself as close to zero as possible. You can use battery disconnects for your house battery. This really helps to just terminate the battery so that there's no way anything can draw power from it. If this is coming from your chassis or engine battery, you can start diagnosing problems up there. Don't forget, when your doors are open, it might be your dome light. It could be your stereo and standby power. But one way you can start to try and track that down is by removing fuses one at a time and then looking at your power meter and see if when you pull a fuse that goes to zero power draw. Then you know that it's something connected to this fuse's circuit. And don't forget about your TV antenna signal booster. It's behind the TV. It's that little dot you can push, has a little green light most of the time. That can be power draw. Lots of little tiny things can add up to a large amount of power draw that's gonna be stealing power from your battery even while you're away from your RV. So battery disconnects are great. That's one way to totally insure it. And if you don't want to go that route, this is a great way to start tracking down that problem. So if that helped, I hope it did. Please like, share, subscribe. My name is Jim with Full Moon Adventure Club. And until the next video, thank you so much for watching and happy camping.